Yeah, I guess, I mean, I still have a couple, like, little sets of collagen patches left, but I wanted to buy a whole bunch because, like I said, they
This
really
does
seem
not
to be
look
helping my
remotely
eyes.
safe.
Or not my eyes, but the skin around my eyes. I'm a very tired-looking boy because I'm a very worn-out individual. I'm a hard worker, not to toot my own horn. But I work very hard and it wears me out. And keeping late hours because I work a late night job certainly isn't helping. Like those collagen patches were. But oh well, maybe I'll find something similar. I think it might have been a Miniso exclusive. I really liked that store. My friend and I went on a trip to Alberta to visit another friend for a couple days, and he's like, "Hey, check out this store. It's Miniso. I think you'll really like it." And we checked in. I'm like, "Man, I fucking love this store. It's got like cute
Where are you
Japanese
taking
shit,
me? Now, why would I tell you?
which is totally my aesthetic." And then I come back to St. Catharines, and I was shopping around for a specific thing. So I was checking. I need a reminder of what stores were at my local mall, and I
Tell
saw
me where you're
Miniso was
going,
there.
dammit!
And I was like, "What the fuck? We don't have a Miniso in St. Catharines." My first time hearing of it was when we were on vacation in Edmonton. And apparently it's been at the local mall for like a month or two, and it's already closing down because no one can fucking see it. Like everything in the mall you can access from the inside. Some things from both inside and outside, but the Miniso you can only access from the outside, and it's not near an entrance, so if you're heading towards an entrance, you're not gonna see it. And I think that's what really shot in the foot was no one knew it was there.
Back off! Leave that alone.
'Cause my girlfriend's sister, she works at the at that mall, and was like, "Yeah, I work 5 days a week at that mall, and I didn't know there was a Miniso there." Like, it doesn't
You don't
even
even know
have,
what you're
like, you know, when
doing.
you pass by a
Just
mall
do whatever he tells
or
you,
a
don't you?
plaza and there's a big sign that lists all the things that are in the plaza, it doesn't even have a sign on that. This Miniso is like the best kept secret of St.
Come on.
Catharines, so no wonder they're fucking closing down. So, yeah, everything was like 20% off and then 30, and now it's 60 and they're closing in 10 days. I bought a bunch of scented stuff and like a lot of beauty supplies because I'm a girl suddenly. Among other things, like little USB cores. It's just a good
Stop that.
store. If look up Miniso and go to the one in your area, if you like just pastel colored cute Japanese stuff, it's got home stuff. It's got all sorts of cool stuff. When we were in Edmonton, we took a plane there, and I realized that I was pretty uncomfortable. 'Cause I didn't like sitting up straight. I wanted to like lean my neck, so I was like leaning on my hand and trying to find a comfy spot. So I bought a neck pillow from there. It was a Princess Bubblegum one from Adventure Time. It was really comfy and really cute. So just go there for your cool, cute shit. I guess that's the summary of it, is if you want cool, cute shit, go to your local Miniso. Show them some love, 'cause my fucking hometown didn't. I mean, I've been there like 4 times since I realized they were open. Which doesn't seem like a lot, but
All
that's
right,
like in the
come
last
out.
couple weeks. Like once a week I
Show
go.
yourself.
What are you even talking to? It's probably just a corpse.
Damn it.
Danny, you big dummy. Don't tell the
This
others about
fucking
this.
place is cursed.
It's just a pile of garbage, Danny. Why you gotta be such a bitch? Look at me, I'm just walking around it like I don't give a fuck. It's a hat.
Look at this.
It says NG Medan. Oh, where that's the man of Medan. It's the Medan hat. It's all coming together. Now I just need to find the man. I'm gonna take another sip. We're gonna stand here awkwardly while I take a sip and the game reminds me that I'm in control. Thanks, game. I
What's
remember.
that noise? What are you
I'm
talking
not
about?
completely retarded.
I don't want to hear anything from you.
You don't even want to chat?
Ocean!
I feel like if I was in a hostage situation like this, I'd be really chatty. Because I'd be like nervous. And when I'm nervous or drunk, as you can tell, I get really chatty. So I'd probably want to ask him about his kids and stuff. I'm like, so what do you do, like, other than this?
Please,
what's your favorite color? Do you like video games and anime? What are your favorites?
Jesus!
If I was ever kidnapped or held hostage, they'd get pretty fucking annoyed.
Oh, Christ. That guy. That guy's probably still right here with us. I mean, you die on a ship, your ghost stays on the ship.
Danny, you're talking a lot of stupid shit.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, Fliss is right. She was the superstitious one. And now even she says you're a bitch, so that's gotta mean something. Huh.
Where did all your friends go?
I don't know what the fuck this is all about, but we gotta keep moving and find Olsen. Now!
What? Why do we have to find Olsen? Why did you guys split up in the first place? You guys are fucking stupid.
Olsen? Merde. Qu'est-ce que tu fais?
Like, how bad is this operation that everyone's like, we gotta find my leader? Like, what do you mean? Why did you guys locked us in a room and then split up and don't know where anyone is? What a stupid situation where I saw that. I saw the hand and I was like, is that gonna move? And then it did and I didn't care. I was over it immediately. Your cheap scares aren't gonna work on me. Is this another premonition? Or maybe it isn't. Dude, that was a premonition. Let's look at it. What are you, stupid? I guess I already know the answer to that. These guys are all stupid.
C'est quoi cette bordel?
Yeah, this is a weird way to end a hallway. I get it. Neither of these characters have seen anything spooky yet. Except maybe now. But I mean, our boy that was losing his shit, he was hallucinating like heads and hands and shit. Whereas this guy is just kind of being a pussy. Whatever he saw was frightening enough to fire his gun at, so that's gotta be something. Can we look at the picture now? That fucking pussy isn't pushing us around. Oh, that man had a demon staff. Hooded man with demon staff. Gotcha. Found during Danny. Got quite a few of these here. Anything else I should know? Why will it not let me check my other tabs? Okay, if I press the big button, I can come into this tab. Okay. Yeah, I don't know how to read these graphs because there's like a big bar up top and then like a smaller bar underneath. Julia just apologizes all the time, which I guess were ups. Ooh. We got some downs, then we got some ups. It's looking pretty even. How about Brad? An up and a down, it's also even. An up and a down, okay. So these are staying even. Whereas this had three downs, three ups. So that should be even too. It doesn't seem to be. I guess maybe some are just mean more than others. Whereas we got just two ups. Okay. What kind of secrets do we have, though? Shit, a lot of these opened up suddenly. I don't know what all the lines connecting all these things mean. But it, seems like kind of unnecessary information. I'll learn more about the Benz, military bandwidth, kitchen knife. Still three more of these. So perhaps I'm a little over halfway through the game already? Hard to say. I guess I'm just going back the way I came. Talk about reusing those assets. I hope a QuickTime event doesn't happen because I'm sipping now. Alright, good. I was able to one-hand this game for just a wee bit. Alright, glad I came all this way for nothing. Danny, I could use your help right about now. I was really hoping it would do the hand scare again. Just fucking double down. I can't walk towards the screen. Does it want me to go towards the screen this way? No, I guess you know what? Danny's just gone. He didn't leave a body, he didn't say goodbye or anything. This has got to be the way to go, because there's nowhere else to go. Jeez Louise, I really shat the bed on that one. I should have set the accessibility options, because I'm fucking crippled, there? Apparently. Oh, there's a vent. Oh, yeah! There it is. When I said yeah, that was just when I was about to start saying this is a jump scare. And then it happened before I could make the thought. Before I could verbalize the thought, it happened. So I just said yeah, there it is. I saw that coming a mile away. I'm surprised they didn't give me a fucking jump scare when I was binocking. Which I guess that was a stupid way to phrase it. When I was using the binoculars and looking at the sea, I'm surprised they didn't give me a jump scare then, because it's not wasting any time. Like in Until Dawn, there were times when there should have been one that there weren't, and it's like, okay, alright, good. You know, lower their defenses, don't always go for it. But in this, it's just always go for it. So I knew that was going to fucking happen. It happened before I could even verbalize the thought. Yeah, what's this? Give it to me. Alright, we got watch over strictly. No unauthorized entry to guarded areas. Do not leave posts until you are relieved by oncoming watch stand-ins. Is that what it says? Watch stander. Okay. My TV does a stupid thing where it cuts off like a centimeter from video games. So if there's something right along the edge of the screen, like within a centimeter, I'm not going to see it. And it's super annoying. It's weird because some games actually seem to know that. Like when I've been editing, when I was doing the Cyber Sleuth playthroughs, or like anything on the PSTV, it puts, I noticed that when I'm recording, there's a black border around the recording footage. And the black border is actually where my TV would normally cut off. So I'm seeing the entire screen sometimes, but a lot of PS4 and PS3 games, it actually just cuts it off instead. Can I not read this? Okay. Oh, it's Perez. I've read about him. But yeah, so it, even like, cause the Cyber Sleuth games, I guess were PS Vita ports. I don't really know what the rule is here, but it seems like PlayStation Vita games or ports of PlayStation Vita games will take the, fuck, I forgot what the term was for when the image is stretched beyond your TV's limits. And believe me, I've tried to change it, because I know there's like monitor options where you can just bring the picture right in to line up perfectly, but my TV is a bit cheap and it doesn't have that. Something's gonna grab me. Oh no, nothing grabbed me, okay. Can I hold on to this? Okay, good. We're holding on to it. Seemed like the smart thing to do. Fucking leave a knife behind. That's just stupid. But yeah, my TV, it's like it's a standard widescreen LCD TV. It doesn't even have an option where I can switch to 4x3. So if I'm like playing a Sega Saturn game, it's just all, it's a little, it's all stretched out. I can't tell my TV to go 4x3. I mean, when I'm streaming or recording a Sega Saturn game, I actually have it set up so OBS will automatically, like, it'll force it into 4x3 mode. So I'm the only person affected by this. If you're watching me stream a Sega Saturn game, it will be in the proper resolution. Oh, I already looked at this. Or if you're watching the video on YouTube, I will change it so that it isn't 4x3 resolution. So don't you worry about that. It's just... Oh! That was a bit creepy. Because it wasn't a jump scare, but it was a bit eerie, and I liked that. But yeah, these are all problems... I don't know why I'm telling you. These are all problems of mine. Why is Brad red text? Oh, I saw that clip just now of him standing up. That was in a premonition. But there was also a premonition of him getting stabbed, so I'm not crazy about that. So how the fuck did they miss him? Did they not check every room? Are they stupid? Be the bee. That's strong. Next time I'm in trouble, I'm gonna say D the D. For, you know, for my real name. Or for the sake of the people watching this, I'll T the T, because I guess I go by TK. I feel like the times I've mentioned my real name, which is Derek, by the way, is probably less than 10 times in all of my YouTube videos. Because it doesn't matter, I'm just TK, don't worry about it. Oh, good thing there was the guy shoving me away before, because this door is fucking locked anyways. But I'm glad we get to see what's going on in Brad's life. And I know that Brad can get stabbed. The Brad stab. And I want to avoid that, because I like Brad, he's my boy. Brad and Fliss, sitting in a tree. F-L-I-S-S. Oh, goodies. I said goodies. That was supposed to be geez and goodness. In case you're wondering why I did that.
This can't be good.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Wait, what's the button to move faster? L1? I haven't been doing that. I did it the one time when it told me, but I haven't done it since. I guess I really haven't needed to. Considering I've been exploring thoroughly anyways. Oh, this just opens. Okay, I was expecting it to just stay locked. Alright. Let's go up these stinky stairs. I can't hold L1 to climb the stairs faster. I tried. Just know that I tried. Let's move towards the screen. I feel like there's something here. There isn't here. There's never anything here towards the screen. So I am moving away from my friends. Which is fine, because they suck. Oh, can I go in here? I'm trying so fucking hard to go in here. Oh, there's a scene and everything. A rather grisly one.
Shit on a shamrock. What happened here?
Well, they all appeared to die in terrible fear. Which really is the best way to die? No, it's probably in your sleep. I think the way I want to die is in my sleep, but expecting it. So I know. Because I know that sometimes you don't want to, like, people don't like the idea of knowing when you're going to die. But as a very tidy person that likes to, you know, tie knots, close off close off unfinished business. I would like to know. Oh, Jesus Christ. That's unnatural. I would like to know when I'm going to die. I totally get that some people don't want to know, and I respect that and I understand it, but I want to know.
Fuck this place.
The fuck was that? Was that like a mask on a hook? Or was it just... was it a... See, that I liked. The jump scare was stupid, but when the door just kind of knocked open a little bit, that was cool. See, though, that's fine. Not really a jump scare. A little cheap, but I still like that. A lot better than just spooky face and loud noise. It's cheap. This is just a toilet. Oh, but it's filling with blood. See, that's cool. I know, can I do it again? Oh my god, is it gonna fill up or is it just... okay.
Buck up, B-boy. Buck up.
It wouldn't let me press circle until the dialogue was finished. But see, I like the spooky shit. The blood filling up was stupid, but I liked it. Whereas if you just give me a loud noise and a scary face, I'm not about that. I pressed R1 thinking it was L1 just now. I didn't even try to go the way that my friends went.
They're close.
Defend our future. Join now. This seems like a weird place to advertise that. Like they're on the boat. They're pretty committed. They've come pretty far. What does this say? Already has a gas mask signed out. That seemed to be the only significant source of information there. Mustard gas. Smells like garlic, mustard, horseradish. I mean, I don't really know what horseradish smells like. Lewisite smells like geraniums. Well, that sounds nice, actually. I wouldn't mind getting bombed with Lewisite. Lewisite? I don't know how to say that. Maybe getting bombed with it will turn my skin inside out. I don't know, but sounds nice.
Get up there.
Oh, is this a puzzle? Do we need a ladder now? I gotta find a ladder to examine high place. Or I can push this box, that works too. That didn't seem very hard to move. I think you were just being a little over dramatic. Is there gonna be a jump scare in here? Oh, we're just crawling right in. Okay. Let me finish this last drink before we move on. Alright, there's a bit more than just one sip left. The next sip will be the last, though.
Julia? Hello?
I kinda like that we're going a different way from my pals, because that means we're not just reusing assets and we're actually seeing new things. Speaking of new things, let's look at this. Alright, a helicopter may touch down. Hopefully that's the Coast Guard and they're coming to help us. Hopefully that's a premonition of the end. And everything's gonna be okay. I got the end of Until Dawn when we knew that there was people coming eventually. And I reached the end of Until Dawn only killing two people. One of which, if you watch that LP, you will hear me describe as complete bullshit, because I was holding as still as possible. Until Dawn had a mechanic where you had to hold the controller still, and it would know, because it would be like measuring where your controller is, and if you stepped outside of its little boundary,
who's that?
It would know you weren't still enough.
Get away!
And I assure you that when that person died, when she died, I was very still. It's just I don't hold a controller the way I think people are expected to hold a controller.